And you fight so valiantly against abortion. One of the main ideas in your head should be, how can I link the doctor or the nurse and the mother who wishes to prove abortion, how can I link them for Christ? Thank you for taking to me, Dr. Gerda. This is what we need to do. They are sinners. We have understanding for them. We also have been sinners. Perhaps not this thing, but some might have had just this thing or other things. And she had one thought, how to win the torturer for Christ. Now, we always had an occasion to speak with the torturers because they got tired of torturing. Torturing is a very difficult task, a very heavy labor. Once I spoke with a torturer, and he asked me, why do you shout when I torture you? I said, well, I shout because I feel pain. And he said, what do you know about pain? You know nothing. How much do I torture you? Half an hour. I can't torture you more because I have to torture so many. You can consume for half an hour, and then you rest, you enjoy yourself in yourself. But I have to torture 8 hours a day, 6 hours a week, since 10 years I do this. From morning until the evening, I hear only one song. Park, ah, park, ah, park, ah. The cries of those whom I meet. In the evening, I'm like mad, tired, and I enter in a pub, get drunk, and then I go home and meet my wife and my children too. That is my life. My pains are bigger than yours. And in a certain sense, it was true. And therefore, the only two coffee breaks. After 2 hours, 3 hours, he would be giving a coffee, he would smoke a cigarette. If you would get a smoker, they would give you a cigarette too. And then we could talk with them. They just wish to enjoy themselves. And we always used this pause to speak to them. And this girl told her torturer, sir, in vain you beat me. You will never beat out from me my love towards God, this is with you. But also my love towards you, and when you hurt me, go away, you stupid girl, you are not in the love business. You should better tell us the secrets of the underground club. And she says, I will tell you something which no girl usually says to a man, but here we are in special conditions, and I will tell you. When you beat me, I look to your hands, I don't know if anybody told you. You have such nice hands. I imagine what a joy your wife had when you caressed her first. So nice to caress, to receive a caress. So why don't you use your hands for caresses? It can caress so well, and you use it for beating. It's caressing, sir, not better than beating. You enjoy it, and she enjoys it. Then why don't you caress? So I will tell you something else which no girl has ever said to a man. You have very attractive lips. I imagine what a joy your wife had when you gave her the first kiss. Kissing is something so beautiful. Your heart jumps for joy. She rejoices, you rejoice. Is kissing not better than swearing, than yelling, than shouting? Then why don't you kiss instead of shouting at her? He was very mad. Stop! Well, let me stop, sir. But I will tell you only one thing more, and then I finish. Every boyfriend. Now, every girl praises her boyfriend, but mine is something entirely else. Not that he loves me. He is love. He's incarnate love. And since I know him, I also can only love. If somebody caresses me, I love him. If somebody beats me, I love him. I can only love. He gave her a box. She fell to the on the concrete. She hit herself at the temple. She passed away soon. And after a few minutes, she came back to herself. She saw him sitting quietly in a chair and saying, you stupid girl, what is the name of that boyfriend of yours about whom you talked? He smiled. I said, you think, have you thought of this? What an idea she has. Caressing, caressing is much more pleasant than beating. Just understood by it. I never thought about it. He's right. And kissing is better than being rude and shouting at somebody else. And he's stupid. In beating and in shouting, instead of caressing him, kiss him. Who's this boyfriend of yours who told you this? She told him the name of her boyfriend. I did not tell you the name. You must guess it yourself. But she told him the name of the boyfriend. Then he said, how can I make him to be my friend too? Then she said, you must repent of your sins. You must be born again. A few words, but we can see in such conditions. And you must be baptized. But what does it mean to be baptized? You have to enter in water with somebody else. He will dip you under the water and will say in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Then baptize me. She said, I can't baptize, which was not true. In such conditions, everybody can baptize, even a child. But she said, I can't baptize. Then the most amazing thing happened. He took out his revolver, pointed the revolver at her, and said, you better baptize me or I shoot you. He fulfilled exactly what Jesus had said. In Matthew 10, Jesus had said, the Son takes the kingdom of God by violence. He wished to enter the kingdom of God, and he never shoot a couple of people for this. He wished to enter, and he dragged her to a pool which was there somewhere, and threw her into the water. He also entered, and she baptized him, and it was a real conversion. He risked his liberty and his life, and brought her to Christ.